Well, good morning. My name is Colin Hart. I'm campaign director for the Coalition for Marriage, and I also work for the Christian Institute. I'm joined on the platform this morning by Fiona Bruce, Member of Parliament for Congleton, David Burrows, Member of Parliament for Enfield Southgate, by Lord Brennan QC, Member of the House of Lords. Jim Dobbin was due to be with us, but unfortunately he can't today because of the funeral of a close friend. And in a moment we shall hear from Lord Carey of Clifton, the former Archbishop of Canterbury. After Lord Carey has spoken, he and other members of the panel will be happy to take questions, and also myself too. But first, I'd like to announce the launch of the Coalition for Marriage. The Coalition has one very simple aim: to support the current definition of marriage and to oppose all attempts to redefine it. The law currently defines marriage as the voluntary union for life of one man and one woman to the exclusion of all others. That understanding of marriage has stood the test of time, and it has been the best environment for raising children. Most people agree that, though death and divorce may prevent it, the ideal situation for a child is to be raised by their married mother and father. In the months ahead, I'm sure we hear a lot about the rights of adults, but we shouldn't lose sight of the best interests of children. Marriage is more than a relationship between adults. It's bigger than that. Marriage has an important role to play in our society. It's part of our common heritage, and it's part of our history. It's bigger than any of us. The word marriage is in legislation 3,258 times. It's woven into the fabric of our national laws, and that can't be unpicked in a single stroke. But marriage predates English law. It predates England as a nation state. It predates the Christian Church. Marriage has been the most successful partnership in history, stretching back thousands of years across cultures and across the world. Marriage was not dreamt up by government, and yet this government cannot simply overturn thousands of years of history by redefining it, especially so when no political party made it part of their election manifesto. If they believe that the public support them on this issue, why didn't the party leaders have the courage of their convictions to put it in their manifestos? They have no mandate for this monumental change to our culture. In March, the government will have a consultation. But the Home Secretary has already said it's a consultation about how and not whether marriage is redefined. The 24 million married people in this country are not even going to be asked whether they mind marriage being redefined over their heads. This is profoundly anti-democratic. The government is running away from this public debate. They are bulldozing ahead without any thought for the consequences. And who is pushing for this momentous change? When candidates were canvassing for votes, did the average voter stop them in the street and beg them to redefine marriage? Of course not. Ordinary people want the government to sort out the economy. They want to feel safe on the streets. They want a decent education for their kids, and they want a national health service we can all be proud of. They are not saying, what I really want from the government is a new definition of marriage. The only people pushing for this are a handful of single interest groups and fans of political correctness. The public have been shut out, ignored, forgotten. Well, the Coalition for Marriage is here to give the British public a voice. We have this morning launched a national petition for marriage. It has been signed by leading public figures, politicians, lawyers, academics, and religious leaders. It has been signed by people of different faiths and people of no faith at all. They have signed it because they very much care about marriage and its place in our society. The petition is open to anyone resident in the UK over the age of 16. It can be signed online on the Coalition's website, c4m.org.uk. That's the letter C, the number 4, the letter m.org.uk. This week, we will be emailing 175,000 people, inviting them to sign online. And we've printed 500,000 petition sheets for distribution across the nation. We're very grateful for the support of Archbishop Vincent Nichols this morning in saying that he will be encouraging people to sign the petition along with the Church of England. I don't think the government truly realises the strength of opposition to its plans. The coalition is no flash in the plan. We intend to defend the current definition of marriage, and we intend to win the debate. No doubt, in the days and months ahead, there may be a great deal of intimidation of those who believe in traditional marriage. Already, we've seen the Archbishop of York faced a racist hate mail simply for saying that marriage should be between a man and a woman. And I would hope that this debate can be conducted in a courteous and reasonable manner. It is perfectly possible to defend traditional marriage while also respecting the rights of others. The fact of the matter is, the rights of marriage are already available to same-sex couples through civil partnership. So the issue is not about rights, it's about redefining marriage for everyone. And when the public are given the facts, when they are told that the rights of marriage are already available through civil partnerships, a majority of the public back traditional marriage. So we believe there is everything to play for in this debate, and we intend to win it and to hold on to the current definition of marriage, the most successful partnership in history.